ज्ञानत मरंदस्य ज्ञानंजनाशलाकाया चक्षुर्मीलितं तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमः विष्णुपदाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्ता स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात्य देशतारिणे वंचकौपात्तरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्येव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्री वासुदेव गौर भक्तवृंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे सो In this second half of the Brihad Bhagavatamrita, we heard about a cowherd boy from Govardhan, how he was giving instruction to a Brahmin from Mathura. And he told the Brahmana about how he traveled to many different places in the material world and then he'd gone into the spiritual world. And we heard about how he traveled in the different places in the spiritual world. And then he came back to Vrindavan on earth. So, well, he's back in earth, he's in Vrindavan. In the forest of Vrindavan, and he's with the Brahmin from Mathura, and they're talking about Krishna. And when they were talking about Krishna, suddenly Krishna appeared. Along with all the cows and the cowherd boys. And we're here, we heard about how Krishna was, when he saw Gop Kumar, Krishna was very happy to greet him, and they embraced each other in ecstasy. And then we heard they went to the Yamuna, and they all took the bath in the Yamuna water. And they were splashing each other with water. And then now they've come out of the water, they came out of the Yamuna water, and there were many lotus flowers in the water, and they brought lotus flowers with them.
And 杨木的河当中盛开着很多的莲花, 他们就采集了一些莲花, 带上了岸。
So they used the stem of the lotus flowers to make garlands for each other.
他们就用莲花穿成了花环, 就给对方呢, 就戴在他们对方朋友的脖子上。
And they decorated Lord Krishna, of course, with beautiful flowers from the Yamuna.
他们也用亚木的河当中的美丽的鲜花来装饰 Krishna.
So then it came time for the cowherd boys to take their lunch. So they sat down along the bank of the Yamuna, and they put Krishna and Balaram in the center, and all the cowherd boys sat around them.
现在到了午餐的时间，所有的人呢就在亚木那河的岸边呢坐了下来，他们把 Krishna 和Balarama 让他们俩坐在中心，所有的牧牛童朋友就围绕着、环绕着他们俩坐在他们四周。
Earlier, they had all taken their breakfast together, but now it is time for lunch.
在这之前，他们曾经都共进了早餐，到现在呢，他们又开始一起共进午餐。Sometimes
Krishna will take his breakfast at home, and sometimes he will take his breakfast in the forest.
Krishna 有的时候在森林当中吃早餐, 有的时候又在家中吃早餐。
Srimad Bhagavatam tells us one day Krishna took his breakfast, he took it with him for a picnic in the forest.
圣典伯加拉巴坛描述说, 有一天, 他们就在森林当中午餐, 开始那个野餐, 在早晨的时候, 他们就去了森林野餐。
And before Krishna woke up early that morning, and when he, after waking up, then he blew his bugle, and he woke up all the cowherd boys and all the calves to let them know that he's getting ready to leave, to go to the forest.
Krishna 一大早就醒来了，他吹响了号角，唤醒了牧牛童朋友，也叫醒了那些牛犊们。
And they would all go together, all the cowherd boys and all the calves, they would all be happy to go into the forest with Krishna.
那些男孩子们还有牛犊们都欢蹦乱跳的，兴高采烈的跟 Krishna 一起去森林。
All right, so now they're going to take lunch, and Krishna personally starts to serve all the cowherd boys.
现在他们又准备坐下来吃午餐了，Krishna就亲自给所有的牧牛童朋友分发食物。They
had all brought wonderful delicacies. Their mothers had made wonderful things for them to take for their lunch, and they all shared them with each other.
这些牧牛童朋友的母亲们都给他们精心准备了美味可口的食物，现在他们就准备在彼此之间分享这些美食。And
Krishna took on the service of distributing prasadam to all the different cowherd boys.
而 Krishna 他就承担起了给牧牛童朋友们派发 prasadam 的服务。
And they also had wonderful fruits. And these fruits were not just what their mothers had packed for them, but they've collected some of these fruits from the forest.
除此之外还有各式各样的水果。这些水果呢，不是来自他们母亲给他们准备的午餐盒，而是他们从森林当中采集的各式各样的水果。
In Vrindavan, there's many different kinds of trees, and they provide many different flowers and fruits and even grains.
在文达文呢，有各式各样的树木，这些树木会盛开出五彩缤纷的鲜花，还有提供了水果，甚至会提供谷物。
And Krishna would enjoy serving the fruits. He knew which particular fruit each cowherd boy liked, and he would serve it to them.
而 Krishna 就亲自承担起了来派发这些食物的服务。他知道每一个牧牛童朋友喜欢吃什么样的水果，就给他们相应的派发这些水果。
Yeah, there are many fruits like amalaka and grapes and jackfruit and bananas.
有阿玛拉卡，葡萄，菠萝蜜，还有香蕉。
And there's other fruits also, names we're not familiar with. There's oranges, and there's different pomegranates and dates.
还有一些水果，我们并不是很熟悉它们的名字，比如有的我们熟悉，就像有橘子，还有菠萝以及枣、椰枣。Pomegranate，石榴。有石榴。
And dates. All of these things grow in the trees in Vrindavan.
这些都是产自本大文的树木。So
only in Vrindavan forest can you find all these fruits ripe at the same time.
只能在本大文才能发现所有这些水果都在同一个时间、同一个季节成熟。And
only in Vrindavan can you find all the flowers decorating, which decorate Krishna. Or decorate the forest of Vrindavan. So it's the special nature of Vrindavan that all the trees bring all kinds of fruits and flowers in every season.
这些文达文的树木，就是一年四季常都会常年都会盛开着各式各样的鲜花，提供所有的这些水果。So
Lord Krishna would stand in front of each of the boys one after another, and he would take a little bit of their food from their plate and eat it.
主Krishna他会站在每一个牧牛朋友面前，从他们面前摆着的餐盘里拿出一些食物放在自己的口中。And
he would feed the boys also. At the same time, he would take a little from their plate. At the same time, he would feed them. He would give them more prasadam. And this way, he would please them.
他不仅会从他们盘中取食物吃，而且他也会亲手给这些牧牛童喂食物，就这样呢，就让这些牧牛童朋友感到很开心。So
Krishna did this with each boy one after another, but every boy, every cowherd boy, they thought Krishna was just with him alone.
实际上 Krishna 是这样一个。 一个接着一个的呢，给他们每一个人跟他们进行这样的交流，但是他们每一个牧牛童朋友就认为，那是在跟他自己在做这种交流。So
Krishna's cowherd boyfriends, they would look at all the different preparations, and then they would pick out which ones they liked.
的这些牧牛童朋友，他们就会找自己喜欢的食物吃。
And then they would pick it with their own hands and then they would feed it into Krishna's mouth. And Krishna would be laughing and he would eat each of their offerings, and sometimes he'd make faces, you know, and say, and he'd make everybody laugh. Yeah, before the boys would feed something to Krishna, the boys would first eat it a little themselves to make sure it was good, and then they would think, yes, this will be good for Krishna.
这些牧牛童朋友在给Krishna亲手喂食之前呢，他们自己先尝一尝，看看味道好吃不好吃，然后才会把食物呢亲手喂到Krishna的嘴里。
Yeah, if they thought this one is really good, then they'd make a big show and put it right into Krishna's mouth. This is really good, Krishna. You'll really like this one.
他们这样一边说着说这样这个是特别好吃的，然后一边呢就把这个食物呢就喂到Krishna的嘴里。So
then the cowherd boys also had some nice drinks to take. They had tamarind nectar, and they had buttermilk and Yamuna water.
同时呢，他们还 喝饮各式各样的饮料，有
tamarind. Yeah, I don't know. Also, I forget tamarind. What word? Any buttermilk? You know buttermilk?
Yes. 也还有牛奶，牛奶还有水。
No, buttermilk is what's happened when you take the fat off the milk. That's buttermilk. You take the fat off of it. There's no fat in it. It's just
脱脂牛奶。
And Yamuna water, fresh water from the Yamuna.
有脱脂牛奶，还有tamarind，以及Yamuna河的清澈的河水。
Yamuna water was so pure, 5,000 years ago, you could drink all the water from the river. Very nice.
就是在5000年前的Yamuna河呢，是特别纯净的，没有污染的，可以直接从喝饮的。So
Krishna would make all the cowherd boys drink, and they would be happy. They would be enjoying with Krishna.
Krishna 呢就会让这些他的朋友们，一边进食呢，一边喝水，然后他们就这样的兴高采烈的就这样进餐。
And they would keep these liquids, they would keep them in bamboo, they had some special bamboo containers, and they had some containers made from leaves folded together to keep the liquids.
他们的杯子呢，有的是用叶子做成杯子，还有的是用那个竹子做成的杯子，水杯。
So then Krishna would do Akshman, you know, to purify his hands. And then he would chew some nice betel nut. You know betel.
Krishna, he
you know.
Krishna, he yes, mother.
Go ahead.
Krishna, he will do archman, 净手净口，然后他就会咀嚼这些食物。
然后他也会咀嚼一些槟榔。槟榔, right. And the槟榔 had camphor, it was very fragrant, it had a lot of camphor in it.
这个槟榔特别好吃, 因为里头就掺了很多的 樟脑。
And each boy had brought their own betel nut from their home, which their mother had made for them.
每一个牧牛童朋友，他们都就是从家中就带来了他们自己的母亲用爱心给他们就是做的这个特别好吃的槟榔。
But they also had some which grew in the forest. There was some betel nut which was growing in the forest, and they took it and they soaked it, and then they wrapped it in many leaves.
在森林当中也会生长出这个槟榔，然后他们就会采集下来之后呢，然后用清水洗一洗，就吃下去。
So Krishna enjoys betel nut, and he would distribute also to the cowherd boys.
Krishna 特别喜欢这槟榔，他自己吃，然后他也会派给朋友。
So when Krishna finished eating like that, he washed his hands, and then he performed. He would sip water to purify himself.
Krishna 吃完之后呢，他就洗一洗手之后，然后他也会啜饮一些清水，然后来净化自己。
And so then after the meal, they take this betel nut, and they would give it to Krishna, and then Krishna would distribute to all the rest. He would distribute it to all the cowherd boys.
他们吃完他们的午餐之后，就开始咀嚼槟榔，他们。然后也给 Krishna 一些槟榔，然后 Krishna 呢也给这些牧牛童又分发槟榔。
So then, the cowherd boys they all made garlands for Krishna. They collected so many flowers and leaves from the forest.
接下来呢，他们就开始给 Krishna 穿花环，他们采集了森林的鲜花和嫩叶。
In Vrindavan forest, there's wonderful flowers. Of course, Tulsi is there, so they collect many Tulsi.
Vrindavan 森林盛产着鲜花，而且有许多的 Tulsi.
And then other flowers like Kunda and Jasmine and Malati.
除此之外，还有昆达花、茉莉花、马拉提花。
And then Madhavi flowers also.
还有名叫 Madhavi 的鲜花。
Oh, there's so many different flowers, all different names. We don't. And they collected flowers from the Kadamba tree.
有许多我们叫不上名字的鲜花。以及来自于卡当巴树的卡当巴花
and Bakula flowers and Champaka flowers,
以及 Bakula 花 Champaka 花
Ashoka flowers and Mandara flowers,
Ashoka 鲜花 Mandara 鲜花
so many different fragrant flowers all collected in the forest.And they put these garlands on Krishna, and they passed the garlands around to different cowherd boys.
有这么多种类的鲜花做成了花环，他们放在戴在 Krishna 的颈上，他们也会把这些花环呢分发给牧牛童朋友戴在各自的脖子上。
So they make.Wonderful garlands like the Vaijayanti garland for Krishna, which means Vaijayanti means has many different kinds of flowers. So.There's a lot of different flowers growing and oh, so many different names. Many flowers grew in the water. Some flowers they get from the water. They would play more and play more of a part in Krishna's waters. When Krishna plays in the Yamuna, Krishna enjoys with these flowers from the water. But sometimes the many water flowers are also used with the forest flowers combined together to make a garland.
除了森林当中的鲜花，他们会采集那个水里，杨木的河当中的水生的鲜花，用这些，一起来串成花环。他们因为他们在水中玩耍的时候呢，他们也很享受这些水生的鲜花。And
the garlands would have flowers and leaves from the trees, like the Kadamba tree.
以及就是森林当中树木，比如说像卡当巴树生长的卡鲜花，以及嫩叶串成。And
Krishna always wore peacock feather on his head, and also he'd have berries of the gunja, berries of gunja. He'd always keep these on his head.
Krishna 头插孔雀羽毛，然后他也会佩戴着。
And Krishna, the cowherd boys, they would make different paste, different substances to put on Krishna's body to give pleasure to Krishna.
牧牛童朋友们会往 Krishna 的身躯上涂上各式各样的这种。 就是这种颜料或者是这种浆液来涂在 Krishna 身上，让 Krishna 感到高兴。Yeah,
things like sandalwood, and then kumkum, and musk.
比如说檀香浆，昆库粉，还有麝香。And
they could find all of these things in the forest, and they would bring them to offer to Krishna for Krishna's pleasure. Yeah, they would get these things, them into a paste and add some water and then grind them on the rock, and in this way they'd make a nice paste and then they smear the paste on Krishna's body.
他们会把这些采集来的呢混合在一起，掺一些水，把它们研磨成浆液，在岩石上磨成浆液之后，涂在 Krishna 身上。And
Krishna would enjoy it. Then Krishna would take some of it and he would put it on his friends.
Krishna 呢很享受，身上涂抹着这些清凉的浆液。
And so you can see, growing in the forest of Vrindavan, you can get so many wonderful things to enjoy. So then Krishna found a very nice place in the forest where there were many nice fragrant flowers and there was a humming of bees, and Krishna lay down to take rest there.
接下来 Krishna 会在森林当中找到一处特别优美的地方，那里盛开着芬芳的鲜花。
And Krishna lay down on this very on the soft leaves and flowers from the forest. And Krishna's friend Sridham was like a pillow. Krishna lay his head on the legs of Sridham.
Krishna 的朋友叫 Sridham， 他的腿现在就变成了 Krishna 的枕头。
And other cowherd boys, Krishna's friends, they would recite prayers.
其他的 Krishna的朋友开始给他吟诵祷文。
And they would be singing to him, and they would fan him.
他们给他唱歌，为他扇凉。
And other boys would be dressing Krishna's hair, and some would be massaging his feet and his hands.
有些朋友会给 Krishna的头，弄他的，梳理他的头发。 还有的给他按摩他的手和脚腿。
So Krishna's bed was so fragrant, so nice smelling that so many bees were attracted there.
呃，Krishna是head，哦，Krishna的头，头，Krishna头是这么的芳香，引来了嗡嗡作响的蜜蜂。
No, no, Krishna's bed was so fragrant. Not his head. Krishna's bed. Because it was all flowers.
Okay. Krishna的，嗯，他现在躺着的这个，由嫩叶和鲜花铺成的这个床啊，是这么的芳香，引来了很多的蜜蜂。
So sometimes Krishna gets tired from playing and fighting with the cowherd boys. He lay down and take rest.
有时候Krishna在森林当中呢，因为跟他的朋友们一起打斗，然后他有的时候就会感到疲劳，之后他就躺下来休息。
And he'll take the lap of a cowherd boy for his pillow. Didn't bring any pillow, he just lay on one of the cowherd boys.
And Krishna, he didn't have a pillow, he would roll the leg of a cowherd boy into a pillow.
And all these cowherd boys, they're all great souls. So they're very fortunate, they're allowed to massage Krishna's lotus feet.
跟他一起玩耍的这些男孩子们全部都是伟大的灵魂，所以他们现在就被允许来为 Krishna 按摩。And
they would, some boys would be singing nice songs suitable for the occasion.
有的男孩子们就唱起了适合此时当时的情景的歌曲。
They'd be thinking how much they loved Krishna. So Krishna enjoyed pleasing all of these cowherd boys, and along with Balaram, they'd have many different pastimes for their pleasure.
Krishna 特别享受和这些牧牛童朋友们的 欢乐的时光，他跟他的哥哥巴拉拉玛就一起跟他们一起享受。So
sometimes they would do things like they try not to laugh, but Krishna would be very expert. He could always get them to laugh.
这些朋友，男孩子们，有的时候他们就使劲忍住不笑。 但是 Krishna 特别擅长逗弄他们发笑。Krishna
could imitate different people, and he would twist his face and distort his face, make faces, and he would tell also many jokes to, and the cowherd boys could not help themselves from laughing.
Krishna 他特别的擅长模仿各式各样的人物，他有的时候就会脸上的肌肉呢就会弄出各式各样的表情，然后模仿各种人物，他也擅长开玩笑。每当这时候呢，他的朋友这些男孩子们就禁不住就会笑出声来。
So the boys, cowherd boys, would be serving Krishna. And Krishna would be entertaining them. He would be pleasing them. So then Krishna played his flute and blew his buffalo horn. And in this way he got all the cows, all the animals to stand up, and he took them to the Govardhan Hill.
Krishna 随后他就会吹响号角, 他也会吹响他笛子, 使得所有的这些动物们都站了起来, 他们就向高尔根山开始进发。
So sometimes the cowherd boys, they would do things like collect different items from the forest to decorate Krishna.
男孩子们会从森林当中呢采集各式各样森林的物品来装饰 Krishna.
Just like some boys would collect tilak, and they'd collect tilak made from haritala, and they'd put nice tilak on Krishna's forehead.
男孩子们会采集一种名叫Haritila的 What is Haritila?
It's a kind of herb.
Okay. 他们就会采集一种药草名字叫Haritila 做成浆液 把Krishna的额头上涂成Tilak.
And some other boys who would make flower garlands to go on Krishna's hair.
还有的男孩子们从森林当中随手就采一些野花做成花环装饰Krishna的头
And sometimes they bring gunja berries to put on Krishna's head.
有时候他们也会采集gunja果来装点Krishna的秀发。
So then in the evening, Krishna left there was a new brahmana there called Jana Sharma. So Krishna left that brahmana with Sarupa, the cowherd boy from Govardhan.
奎什纳就让一位新来的詹纳沙玛的原上一世是詹纳沙玛的这个婆罗门，这一世就成为了文达文的牧牛童，让这位牧牛童新来的牧牛童和格尔丹山的格帕库玛这位牧牛童朋友，让他们俩一起过夜。
Yeah, Jana Sharma, he's a brahmana from Mathura. He's a newcomer.
Jana Sharma, 他是一个新来的，他原来是Mathura的婆罗门brahmana.
But Gopkumar is not a newcomer. Gopkumar, he's Sarupa, and he's a friend of Krishna.
Gopakumar, 他不是新来的，他是Krishna的朋友，他现在名字叫Sarupa.
So, in the evening, Krishna decided he's going to go home, and he went back to the village, to the cowherd village.
夜幕降临的时候，Krishna决定回家，他决定就回到他的村庄。So
Krishna goes back to the village to be with his father, goes to his father's house.
傍晚时分，Krishna就带着这些朋友们一起回到他的养父的家中。So
Krishna told Sarupa to take care of the new man, the brahmana from Mathura.
Krishna就命令 Sarupa 来照料新来的这位朋友。
So you see, actually, this is, we've actually come to the end of the story. So Parikshit is speaking to his mother. You see, the beginning of the book, it was Parikshit's mother wanted to hear from her son about Krishna.
讲到这里呢，我们的故事就接近了尾声了。现在的场景就是 Parikshit 的王，他现在在跟他的母亲在讲话，而这个整个的这段消时光开始的时候，也是起源于 Parikshit 和他的母亲的对话。So
Parikshit tells his mother that you have good intelligence by the mercy of Krishna.
Parikshit 就对他的母亲说， 由于 Krishna 的仁慈， 您拥有优良的智慧。
So you can answer any questions you have by everything, by what you've heard from us, you should now be able to answer all your questions.
他对他的母亲这样说道， 从我们所讲述的所有这一切， 您就可以回答您心中的问题了。
Right, in the beginning, Parikshit's mother had come to him, to her son, and she asked him questions. She had things she wanted to know about Krishna.
最初的时候， Parikshit的母亲就接近他自己的儿子， 想要了解有关于Krishna的事迹。
So they gave Parikshit the opportunity to tell her about the Brihad Bhagavatamrita.
Parikshit 就趁此机会就讲述了整部的大波迦塔甘露。
Right, Parikshit's mother is called Uttara, right?
是的，就是 Parikshit的母亲的名字叫 Uttara.
And in the beginning, she had come to Parikshit and she had asked him. She said, please tell me, what did Sukadeva Goswami teach you? And tell me quickly, just tell me the essence. So because we don't have a lot of time, so you have to tell me quickly.
Uttara 就接近他自己的儿子 Parikshit, 对儿子恳求道, 请你给我讲述一下简明扼要的讲述一下 Sukadeva Goswami 你讲的内容，因为现在时间不多了。
Because Parikshit's cursed to die, you know, he only had 7 days to live. So he'd heard the Srimad Bhagavatam from Sukadeva Goswami, and there was some time left, and he was just waiting for the time for death. So his mother came and she said, you know, please tell me quickly.
Parikshit大军受到诅咒，在七天之内死去。 Sukadeva Goswami 就给他讲述了七天的圣典薄伽瓦坛。讲述完之后，还剩下一点时间，Parikshit大军才会离开这个地球。所以趁着这个剩下的这点时间，他的母亲就来找到他，请求他给他讲述 Krishna。
So there are two parts to the Brihad Bhagavatamrita. We only spoke on the second part.
但薄伽瓦坛是分为两部分，我们只是讲述了第二部分。Yeah,
after we finish the second part, we can go back and we'll speak on the first part.
我们讲述完这个第二部分之后，我们就翻过头来再回去讲第一部分。So
for the second part, Uttara wanted to know if there's anywhere higher than Vaikuntha.
第二部分的内容主要就是讲乌特瓦，乌特瓦想要了解有没有比瓦昆特更高的领域。Is
there any place where Krishna's devotees can associate with him intimately?
有哪个地方 Krishna的奉献者可以在那里跟他有亲密的交往？
Because in Vaikuntha, they don't get so much chance to associate intimately with Krishna.
在百昆特，他的奉献者没有机会能够跟他有亲密的交往。
And so Uttara asked Parikshit to tell her about this.
Uttara 就请求 Parikshit 向他解释这一点。
Uttara is saying that there must be some place beyond Vaikuntha. So please tell me about it.
Uttara 说道，一定有一个地方甚至超越了 Vaikuntha， 请你多讲述这一地方。
So Parikshit is speaking to Uttara, his mother, and he tells her that, my dear mother, you should try to reach Goloka.
Parikshit 就对他的母亲说，妈妈，母亲呢，有一个地方比百昆特更高，那就是 Goloka， 请你要真达 Goloka。
Yet you get the ultimate perfection you're looking for there in Goloka.
在 Goloka， 你就会寻找到你想要的终极的完美境界。
There in Goloka, you'll be able to enjoy loving exchange with Krishna.
在 Goloka， 你就能够找到跟 Krishna 有亲密交流的机会。
So Parikshit wants to help his mother to find the answer to her question at the place higher than Vaikuntha.
Parikshit 王希望自己的母亲，寻找到他内心的问题的完美的答案。
And he tells her, Goloka.You can only go there by the special mercy of Krishna.
他还告诉自己的母亲，只有凭借 Krishna 的特殊仁慈才能够去 Goloka.
But still, everybody should try by their own efforts to go there.
尽管如此，每个人都应该竭尽所能的去那里。
And they should be confident and they should be enthusiastic that they're doing good practice and that they have qualification to go there.
他们应该对自己有信心，并且有对自己的修行有信心，有满怀热情，以至于他们可以去那里。
Because if a devotee doesn't care about going there, then Krishna, he won't get Krishna's attention. Krishna gives his attention to those who really want to go there.
因为倘若一个修行者他不在乎去不去那里的话， Krishna 就也会不在乎这个人，因为 Krishna 只会对那些有这种目标、内心嘛，怀着这种渴望的奉献者，给他们以特殊的照顾。
So it's not that just anybody anytime can go there.
不是说在任何时间任何人都可以去的。
It's not just by going to Vrindavan on earth that you can become qualified to go to Goloka.
也不是说一个人只要去了地球上的Vrindavan，他就有资格能够去Goloka。
It's only a rare person who can get the real mercy of Krishna。
只有非常罕见的、少见的人物才能获得 Krishna 真正的仁慈。
So you have to, the Parikshit tells his mother, you should take the dust.From the feet of the devotees who have this pure love for Krishna.
Parikshit 就告诉母亲说，你必须要从那些拥有对 Krishna 纯粹的爱这样的奉献者的莲花足，去取得这样的奉献者的足下的尘土。
Yeah, Mother Uttara.She's because she had heard from her son Parikshit, she had heard that you could get perfection simply by going to Vrindavan.
母亲 Uttara 曾经听自己的儿子说过，只要去了文大门，地球上的文大门就可以达到完美。
Because that Vrindavan is not different from Goloka in the spiritual world.
因为地球上的文大门和灵性世界的 Goloka 是一模一样的。
But Parikshit says it's not so easy to understand the love which exists between Krishna and his devotees.
但是 Parikshit 又说，要想明白 Krishna 和他的奉献者之间的爱，不是那么轻而易举的。
Krishna came on this planet for only a short time. When he appeared here on this planet, he was only here a short time.
当 Krishna 降临这个地球的时候呢，他只在地球上停留了短暂的时间。
He came at the end of the Dwapara Yuga in one day of Brahma, just one time.
Krishna 只在主 Brahma 的一天当中，的其中的一个 Dwarpa Yuga， 同期年代的末尾的时候才降临地球一次。
So, anyone who visits Braja during that time, they can become perfect.
就在那个期间，如果有谁曾经拜访了文达本，他就能达到完美。
Because Krishna had come to the earth, so he was giving mercy to all the devotees, to all the jivas.
因为 Krishna 他亲临地球，所以就给所有的灵魂，所有的 jiva 个体灵魂以仁慈。
But at other times, when Krishna is not personally manifest, then it's different.
但是在其他的，除此之外，其他的时间 ，Krishna 没有展示的时候，情况就是不一样。
You need to get the mercy from a very dear devotee of Krishna.
那是需要。你一个人是需要获得 Krishna 一个非常钟爱的奉献者的仁慈。
Just like this Brahmana from Mathura, he was very fortunate because he got the association of the cowherd boy Gop Kumar from Govardhan.
就像这位 Mathura 的 Brahmana 的例子，他获得了来自高尔丹山的一个牧牛童 Gopa Kumar 的仁慈。
So Parikshit tells his mother, don't waste your time to associate with people who are only interested in liberation.
Parikshit 王告诫自己的母亲，请您不要浪费时间跟那些只对于获得解脱感兴趣的人联谊。
He wants his mother to find out the devotees who only want Krishna, they want only love for Krishna. Find out these people and associate with them.
他劝导自己的母亲去寻找那些，内心只想要获得对 Krishna 的爱的奉献者，之后和这样的奉献者联谊。
And take the dust from their feet and keep it on your head.
去拾取他们足下的尘土，放置在自己的头顶。
And that way, then her visit to Vrindavan will give her perfection.
以这样的方式，她对拜访 Vrindavan 才能够达到完美。
Okay, so we'll stop here.
好，我们正课部分就讲到这里。接下来我们看一下问题。 问题是来自于 Brajarani。顶拜 Gurudev， 感谢尊敬。有一个奉献者，他一直想把Krishna Kumar Maharaj，
顶拜 Gurudev， 感谢尊敬的翻译马塔吉。有一个奉献者，他一直跟把他带进 Krishna 知觉的老师学习经典。这个老师一直教导他们，就跟他学习，不让他们听其他的老师的课。这个奉献者现在每天听了 Guru 的课以后，发现他老师的教导与 Guru 的教导有些差异，他就想从他老师那里走出来听 Guru 的教导。可是他恐惧他的老师，说他老师挺有力量的，害怕他如果不听老师的教导，老师会诅咒他。他也害怕他这么做是不是冒犯他的老师。Hare Krishna。
Brother Rani said, basically, Gurudev, there is a devotee. This, she learned scripture from a person.From a teacher who had brought her into Krishna consciousness, and this teacher told her that only to learn from herself, and not allow the students to listen to the class lecture of other teachers. But since this devotee has listened to the lecture of Guru, and she found that her teacher's teaching is different. There are some difference with Guru's teaching. Therefore, she want to drop off from her teacher and only listen to Guru's teaching. But she is afraid of her teacher, former teacher, because this teacher has some power and.She is afraid that if she didn't listen to her teacher's lecture, her teacher will curse her. And she is also afraid that if she drop off from listening to her former teachers, and will make offense to her former teacher.
Oh, my goodness.Well, this is a very unusual situation. Certainly in ISKCON, it's not a very good practice that somebody is telling her students that they should only hear from her and not from somebody else.
所以这是一个非常少见的情况，就是在 ISKCON 国际 Krishna 这协会当中，这种情况很少见。就是一个老师，他只要求学生听他自己的讲课，听他自己的话，不听别的老师的话。
We encourage everyone, first of all, you hear from Prabhupada, and you take Prabhupada first of all as your teacher, and you hear from Prabhupada.
我们鼓励每个人，第一件事就是把是个 Prabhupada 的当做自己的老师，聆听Srila Prabhupada的教导。
And then the teachers have to present Prabhupada's teaching.
老师要呈现Srila Prabhupada的教导。
Of course, Srila Prabhupada doesn't just present his own teaching, he presents the teachings of all the acharyas.
师的帕布帕他呈现的不是他个人的教导，师的帕布帕呈现的是先前阿查亚们的灵性宗师的教导。
So something is wrong that this lady is teaching and she's not allowing you to hear from somebody else. This is not the process.
所以这个就有问题，是错误的。这位老师他不允许学生去聆听别的老师的教导，只允许他的学生听他自己的教导。
So I think you have to be bold, and you have to find out. You have to ask her. You can approach her yourself, and or if you feel uncomfortable, is this lady attached to a center? Is she teaching you? Is it through a center of Krishna consciousness? Or you don't have any center where she is? There's no other devotees?
那么你就应该勇敢，鼓起勇气。就是这，应该你可以亲自去来跟他，亲自来跟他问这些话。那如果你自己呢感到不舒服的话，那另外一种情况就是说，那这个女老师她有没有跟任何一个 Krishna 知觉的中心有联系呢？因为在这个中心通常会有其他的年长奉献者。
You definitely want to be in touch with some Krishna conscious center where there are senior devotees. You cannot just depend on one person.
就是有一件确定无疑的事情，就是说你应该依附于一个 Krishna 知觉的中心，因为在这个中心的话，它会有多位年长资深的奉献者。
Just like a Krishna conscious, a spiritual master in the Krishna consciousness movement may give initiation, but he will not say just hear from me and don't hear from other people.
在 Krishna 之间当中的灵性导师会有一位领导师给予启迪，这位启迪的领导师他不会命令门徒你只听我的，你不要听别人的。
He will encourage the disciples that they should take advantage to associate with other devotees and hear from them.
他会鼓励从他那里获得启迪的门徒去另。机会去聆听其他的奉献者的教导。
And especially, you want to be hearing from Srila Prabhupada.
尤其是你应该希望能聆听 Srila Prabhupada 的教导。
We read Prabhupada's books and listen to Prabhupada's lectures.
阅读 Srila Prabhupada 的书籍。聆听十个巴巴德的讲课。
So you have to be bold and decide what you want to do. Are you going to stay simply with this one woman, or are you going to become a member of the Krishna consciousness movement?
那你自己就需要勇敢，自己来做决定。你是想要？跟这个单独的这一个女奉献者，跟她在一起呢，还是你想要在跟整个 Krishna 这些运动留在一起呢？
Now, if you want to be a member of the Krishna consciousness movement, you have to contact a center and you have to get in touch with some senior devotees.
如果您自己下决心，我决定我要成为 Krishna 知觉运动的一个成员的话，那您就需要找到一个中心，然后跟这个中心的年长的奉献者接触，联系上。
Actually, the lady who brought you to Krishna consciousness and who's been giving you instruction, she should have done this. She should have arranged to bring you into the association of devotees.
事实上呢，就这位把您带到 Krishna 知觉中来的这位女士，她自己就应该做出这样的安排，让您呢 跟别的奉献者联谊。
So you try to take care of this and try to rectify your situation, put yourself into association with devotees.
就是请您呢自己来处理好这件事儿，来纠正这种错误，然后去努力去跟奉献者们联谊。
Yes. Okay. Next question.
The next one. Maharaj, 主持人，所有奉献者 ，Parikshit 国王即将死亡，给母亲讲述了大伯加瓦谈，这是与他母亲告别，还是担心他悲痛欲绝呢 ？Uttara 只有他一个儿子。Panchatattva Prabhu paid obeisance to you and all devotees and hosts, and since Parikshit Maharaj.It's going to pass away, it's going to die. And before that, he related the Brihad Bhagavad Charita to his mother. He did this. The purpose is to say farewell to his mother, or Parikshit Maharaj is worried.His mother will suffering so much from separation from the child, and because the mother only had one son. So what's the purpose? Is to say farewell or to console his mother?
Well.It's not just simply to console his mother, but it's to give spiritual instruction. His mother came, it was his mother who came to him inquiring. His mother wanted to get more knowledge, more information.
就这个目的呢，不是为了安慰他自己的母亲，目的是为了给他自己的母亲灵性教导。是他的母亲主动地找到了他。所以他希望给予他母亲知识。
Yeah, his mother is a great devotee. Uttara is a very great devotee. She's not in the bodily concept of life. And she understands that her son is going to go back to Godhead.
他的母亲本身就是一位奉献者，没有躯体化的生命概念，他知道明白到他的儿子会即将回归神手。
So there's nothing. It's actually all the arrangement of Lord Krishna to allow the speaking of Brihad Bhagavatamrita for the benefit of people in the Kali Yuga.
实际上是主 Krishna 安排的，就允许这部《大伯加瓦谈纲录》这部著作得以讲述，以便给卡利年代的这些灵魂们带来好处。
Just like Bhagavad Gita, it's not just spoken for Arjuna's benefit, but it's for people everywhere in the Kali Yuga.
就像 Krishna 给 Arjuna 讲述伯加梵歌，目的是为了，他不是为了仅仅是给 Arjuna 个人来讲这部教导，而是为了给 Kali 年代的所有的灵魂讲述这门教导知识。
Okay, yeah.
下一个问题。下个问题是。来自于 H， 所有奉献者，当今社会人们破坏环境，媒体 播放恒河被污染的画面。杨木的河恒河表面上看被污染了，事实上圣河真的会被污染吗？Obeisance to Guru and all devotees, and now the people in the society, they pollute the environment, and there are the pictures, the Ganga has been polluted, and apparently Ganga and Yamuna had been polluted, but well, these two rivers really polluted.By people?
Well, yes, they can put a lot of pollution into the Ganga and into the Yamuna. The water itself of the Ganga and the water of the Yamuna is always pure, but there's a lot of things in the water which is not pure.
是的，人们像这个恒河雅木呢和倾倒很多的污物。恒河和雅木呢河水本身是不会被污染的，问题就是在恒河以及雅木的河水当中有很多很多这种污染物。
Of course, if it's just bubbles forming mud,We don't worry about it, but if there's a lot of chemicals and other things like that, then we're careful about bathing in these kind of places.
如果呢，这两条河当中只是有泡沫，泡沫泥泞的话是没有问题的。关键是现在这两条圣河当中呢，有很多的化学品。所以呢，我们就会很在里头沐浴的时候就会要小心了。
Now that you see, the Yamuna used to be very polluted, but because of the lockdown and the pandemic, so a lot of industry has been stopped, and the Yamuna has become very nice and clean now.
现在呢，由于疫情的原因，很多地方呢就被关闭了、封闭了，不让任何人进入。所以我们看到现在的雅木的河水的状况呢，就是情况好多了，也洁净多了。
So the water of the Yamuna is pure, but sometimes people, are, you know, we're not pure, and we put our contamination.We put a lot of things which are not pure into the Ganga.
雅木的河水本身是纯洁的，但是因为人们不纯洁的人们向纯洁的雅木的河水中倾倒了不纯净的物质，所以就污染了纯洁的雅木的河。
But still, people with knowledge, they'll go and bathe in the Ganga regularly.And they will get great spiritual benefit.
有知识的人仍然会毫不犹豫的在有规律的在恒河中沐浴，以便得到灵性的益处。
Yes. Next question.
Next question. 下一个问题是来自于静心瑜伽。我一遍又一遍地说，在曼谷拉尔体间之前念完圈数，别无其他方法。我可以向任何人保证，在曼谷拉尔体前念完十六圈遵守四项原则，你这一生一定会回归神守，这是个保证。但期间，如果你在做其他的事情，而在早上五点和晚上九点之间念诵，那我就不能保证会发生什么了。顶拜咕噜及所有奉献者，以及以上是我看到的一篇关于早起念诵的一段文字。请问咕噜，对于一个新人，我们该怎样正确理解这段话？对于还在工作并且身体还在康复过程中的人，我们也应该遵循 五点前这样的时间内完成自己十六圈吗？ So there is a statement. This devotee said that she had read a statement about chanting japa. The statement said that I can say again and again that there's only one way that we can go back. I said it once again and again that finish your rounds before Mangalarti. There's no other way. I can guarantee to anybody that if one finish 16 rounds before Mangalarti and follow four regulative principles in this lifetime, he is sure to go back to Godhead. This is the assurance. But if you do other things during the period of Mangalarti and finish your rounds between 5 a.m. and 9 a.m., then I cannot guarantee anything. I cannot make that guarantee. Obeisance to Guru and all devotees, this is a paragraph I saw about chanting in the morning. My question is that as a new fighter, how can we understand this sentence correctly? For one who had a job and the body is still in the period of recovering, should we also follow the procedure to finish 16 rounds before 5 a.m.?
Well, I think it's very difficult for most devotees to do that. And certainly Srila Prabhupada never said like this. And we see in Lord Chaitanya's Shikshastikam, Lord Chaitanya said there are no hard and fast rules for chanting the holy name. Of course, it's a very good practice if somebody is able to do this, you know, get up at 2 o'clock in the morning and chant your rounds before Mangalarti. Okay, you know, some people can do it, not many people.
清晨凌晨两点钟就起床，然后念诵在Mangalarti早晨的吉祥灯仪之前就念诵完十六圈，这是很好的。但是不是很多人都能做到。This
is not something which we would want to ask new devotees to do.
这个不是我们希望新奉献者能够做到的。We
have to first of all let them get attached to Krishna and become attached to the chanting of the holy name.
我们首先让新人能够依附 Krishna, 依附唱诵圣名。And
gradually as they go on in Krishna consciousness, then as they become more advanced, then they may want to do like that.
那随着他们在 Krishna 知觉当中取得进步之后，他们就会主动自发的想要去这么做。So
at the end of life, you can do like that.
所以在人生的末尾，人可以怎么去做？
Yeah, devote put more emphasis on the chanting of the holy name and wake up very early and chant before Mangal Aarti.
就是在人生最后的阶段呢，可以强调要唱诵圣名，早起，然后在 Mangal Aarti 之前能够完成他的宣誓。
But I have not seen this instruction anywhere in Prabhupada's teaching.
但是我没有在释迦牟尼佛的我没有看到在任何地方看到释迦牟尼佛有这样的教导。
And we have to consider about other services. If we have other services to do, and sometimes we have to be up late at night because we're doing other services, and it's not so possible to wake up so early.
有的时候呢，因为我们从事其他的服务，所以我们就会睡得晚。如果这样的情况之下，清晨呢就很难做到早，就那么早起床。
Anyway, everything depends on time and the place and the circumstances.
一切要根据时间、地点、场合。
So if one is able to do like that, then very good. We appreciate that. Very nice. It's good you're doing.
就关键就是谁要是能够这么做的话，那就是太棒了。我们非常欣赏能够这么去做的，那就只是太好了。
Otherwise, other people cannot do it. We don't say you can't go back to Godhead. I wouldn't say you can't go back to Godhead. We have to see the quality of their devotional service.
那对于其他的人来说呢，我们就不能说，你不这么做就不能回归神手了。我们那时候要看的是他们所从事奉献服务的品质。
The main thing is you have love for Krishna.
人必须要拥有对 Krishna 的爱。
And we have to check.
Hi, Krishna.
Yeah. Okay.
Sorry, Mark.他引用这个话是塔玛纳·克里斯纳·高斯瓦米在美国休斯顿庙宇里说的话，当时的那个环境，跟我们中国情况不一样。以前我们问过你这个问题，你说塔玛纳·克里斯纳这句话是在休斯顿当时的社团中出现的一些问题，不念诵啊，或者是懈怠，在那种情况下。他们奎神姑说的这句话，所以静心瑜伽妈呢，他引用这个话，他应该告诉我们是谁说的，出处是什么地方。所以这句话是他们奎神姑说的话，在休斯顿说
的。Right. Okay. So I said that special according to time, place, and circumstance. So the circumstances in that particular place are different from other places.
所以确实就是应该按照时间、地点、环境，什么事情都应该根据这个来看。所以这段话呢，出处是 Tamakrishna Goswami 他当时讲这个话的时间是由于当时是在地点是在休斯敦社团，当时的环境呢是。当时的社团当中，有的奉献者不念诵，而且很松懈懈怠的情况之下，他说的这个话。
So we should not take these instructions out of context. You have to consider everything in terms of the particular circumstances in which that instruction was given.
因此呢，我们就要看这一段话的出处，他当时说这一段话。他的背景是在什么样的大环境之下说出这样的话，不能单独的摘出这样一段的话，要根据他说这个话他当时的大背景。
So it was a special instruction, special circumstance.
所以这个教导呢是针对当时的环境，根据当时的那个社团在那个时间所给予的特殊的教导。
The main thing is to get people to chant the holy name.
那么我对于我们来说最主要的，我们是想要人们念诵圣名。
Anytime you can chant, there are no rules in the chanting of the holy name.
人在任何时间都可以念诵圣名，没有任何硬性规则。
But initiated devotees must complete 16 rounds in the course of the day.
一个启迪了的奉献者，他必须在一天之内完成16圈。
And Prabhupada himself gave a process by which we could chant. He said, first of all, chant 4 rounds in the morning, then chant 4 rounds after breakfast, then chant 4 rounds after lunch, then chant 4 rounds after supper.
是个 Prabhupada 自己呢，他就给出了一个唱诵的这个方法，早晨清晨四圈，早餐之前四圈，午餐之前四圈，晚餐之前四圈。
So we never heard everybody has to wake up and chant 16 rounds before Mangal Aarti.
我们没有听说过就这样的硬性规则，说每个人都必须在清晨 Mangal Aarti 之前完成16圈。
Of course, it's very good if you can do it, but it's not everybody can do that. Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个问题是来自于 Yuna Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. Please accept my humble obeisances. If a person is born in lower forms of life, like an animal or a plant, what is the punishment for him? After all, he does not remember that he was a man and does not understand in what position he found himself. 这个问题是 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。倘若一个人诞生于低等的生命形式，比如说投生为动物或者植物，那么对他的惩罚是什么？毕竟他并不记得他曾经为人，而且也不理解他现在他自己的处境如何。
Yes, but the consciousness is restricted, so that's the punishment.
确实的，但是呢，他的知觉是受到限制了的，这就是对他的惩罚。
He doesn't have the opportunity to take up devotional service.
他没有机会来从事奉献服务。
He's greatly, greatly restricted in all of his activities due to the body which he's given.
由于他现在被给予赐予的这样的躯体，他的活动受到了严厉的限制。
You may say, they don't know, the soul doesn't know his suffering is in that body. Yeah, they don't know. It's true, they don't know their suffering, but they are suffering.
您可能会说这个灵魂他并不知道他自己在受苦啊，但是事实上他确实正在受苦呢。
Yeah, really. When they come to the human life, then they can understand what they've been through.
如果他们来到了人体生 境，他就能明白了他正在处境经历的什么样的状态。
At least we don't remember that we had these bodies, but we know we've been through many different bodies in the past.
我们虽然已经忘记，已经记不住我们以前都投生过什么样的躯体，但是我们知道我们曾经是在很多躯体当中都经历过。
And we should be very careful.To take precaution that we don't have to go through all these different bodies again.
而且我们要小心谨慎，不要让自己再次经历在所有这些种类的躯体当中再度的投生。
Because it just delays, it delays the time before we can go back to Krishna.It will take longer before we can go back to Krishna.
Okay. 不然的话，我们回归神手就需要更长的时间才能回去了。
And maybe we will never go. Maybe we will just stay in this material world and take birth again and again.
而且呢，也许呢，我们就永远。无法回归神手，要留在这个物质世界，反反复复的生死轮回。
And to take birth in these different species of life, it's not very pleasant.
在这些不同种类的生命形式当中投生，不是一件令人愉快的事情。
You may say that.Where is the suffering? But there is suffering. Just the fact that you have that body, if you become a dog, or you become a tree, there's a lot of suffering in that body.
您可能会说，投生在这样的躯体当中有什么痛苦呢？但是，倘若是投生在狗的躯体，或者是树木的躯体当中，仅仅是这个事实，就是有很多的受苦，仅仅是在这个躯体当中，这个躯体本身就是一个痛苦。
You may be thinking, well, they don't know that they're suffering. They don't know that this is a punishment, but it is. It's a punishment just to be in that body, because it's so miserable condition of life.
您可能说，您可能反驳说。那他们也不知道啊，他们并不觉得他们在吃肉苦啊，也不觉得自己是受到了惩罚，但是答案是，他们确实是在受苦，是受到了惩罚，仅因为他们处在这样的躯体当中，他们处在这样的生命状态当中，这个事实本身就是一个痛苦。
And if you can't, if just like one young man, he said to Prabhupada, he said, I don't see anything wrong in being a dog. They have a good time, they run around, they play with each other. So Prabhupada said to him, then I give you my blessings. Go ahead, become a dog.
有一个年轻人曾经对石勒帕帕德说，我不觉得当狗有什么不好的呀，你看。他过得也挺快活的，跑来跑去的玩啊什么的。那石勒帕帕德就给他的回答是：那我祝福你成为狗，你就这么去吧，你就接着就是当狗去吧。
So the same way you're saying, you know, where's the suffering? So go ahead. If you think they're not suffering, go ahead. Become a tree. Become a dog.
那如果一个人说啊，我不觉得那有什么苦啊，当狗或者当树，那好吧，那你就去吧，去当狗，去当树吧。
But we don't want devotees. We understand there is a lot of suffering in these different lower forms of life.
我们不想有这样的投生，奉献者可不想要这样的投生，不想要经历这样的痛苦，在低等的物种当中投生的痛苦。
下一个问题。
好，下一个问题，下一个问题是来自于78828，至尊天鹅是哪位？ So the question is that who is that Paramahansa?
Who is Paramahansa?
Is that he or she is asking the Supreme, the Paramahansa is who? We
invite this devotee to write more sentences and we see the next question. Yeah.
下一个问题来自于 Vivo 93393。
哎，是
的。哎，好，一位。
那个 Gordy， 我想他是问，想问什么样的人是能成为是至尊天的。
嗯 ，Okay. So Paramahamsa.It's the final stage of sannyas.
至尊天鹅是托钵僧的最后一个阶段，就是托钵僧有不同的阶段，其中一个最后一个阶段叫 Paramahamsa 至尊天鹅阶段。
The swan, one of the special skills of the swan is that it can separate milk from water. So if there's water,And milk together, the swan can drink the milk and leave the water.
天鹅呢有一项特殊的技能，天鹅能够从水，就是牛奶和水的混合物当中呢，只喝饮这个牛奶，然后把牛奶喝完，就是把水都剩下来。
So the Paramahamsa person knows the art of taking the spiritual particle from the material world.
这个Paramahamsa人物，他知道这样一门艺术就是融合 how to take the spiritual particle,
take the spirit, the spiritual energy from the material world.
这个至尊天鹅他知道如何从物质世界分离出灵性的能量。
Paramahamsa means is totally detached from all conditions of life.
至尊天鹅就意味着不依附各种各类的物质的生命状态。
And he will be going everywhere preaching the message of Krishna consciousness.
至尊天鹅会去每一个角落传播 Krishna 之觉。
Srila Prabhupada wrote one letter describing his plans for travel.
Srila Prabhupada 曾经写下了一段他的旅行计划。
He described, he said, I will be in Australia, I'm going to Sydney for Rathyatra,And then from Australia, then I'm coming to Mayapur, and we will attend Gorpunima festival.
He wrote in this plan, I will go to Australia in Sydney to attend Gorpunima festival. After that, I will go to Mayapur to attend Gorpunima festival.
And after Gorpunima, then I will go to London, and I will be in London.
之后我从马普去伦敦。
And then from London, I will go to America. He said, in this way, he said, you can say, I am Paramahamsa. I am Jet H. Paramahamsa.
Jet age.
Oh. Feiji the Ninda.
Okay.
Right. Paramahamsa can also be somebody who just stays in one place. He doesn't travel at all.
至尊天鹅也可以是一位
He doesn't worry even about food or anything. If people bring food, he will eat. If nobody brings food, he will not eat. He will just go without food. This is Paramahamsa, totally detached. So Paramahamsa is there, the most elevated, most renounced, most detached in the spiritual life.
所以一位至尊天鹅就是在灵性生活当中彻底的不依附的这样一位崇高的人物 下一个问题是来自于顶拜威德波顶拜见爱的咕噜亲人想起离工作室看护打扫公共厕所 休息也在公厕里可以念诵，但这种情况，念诵圣名可以用念珠念吗？ 如果不在念上念，用计数器算数吗？ So this devotee paid obeisance to dear guru. If one new devotee want to get initiation, therefore this new devotee, he took the job to take care of the public. Toilet and even rest in the public toilet WC and chant, but under the circumstances, can he chant on the beach? If not, can he chant on the counting counter? Is this okay to chant on the counter?
Yes, it's okay to chant on the counter, and maybe it's okay even to chant on the beads.
可以在念计数器上念，甚至可以在念珠上念。
Sometimes, you know, I mean, he's only sitting there in the toilet, taking care. So he must have some table there where he sits, he's taking care of the toilet, so he can sit there at the table and he can chant.
有的时候呢，他工作，他的工作的环境是，他可以坐在那个一个桌子后面，然后呢，他就可以这样子坐在那个桌子后面念诵。
Okay, it might be better to use the counter rather than the beads. It's certainly probably better.
如果呢，用计数器要比用念珠更好。
Keep the beads for chanting at home.
他回家可以用在念珠上念。
OK， 下一个问题。
那你来静心瑜伽。OK， 哦、This devotee is showing thankfulness to your instruction about and the statement about chanting 16 rounds. And thank you, Rajendra Prabhu. The next question is that continue. Guru 不是有不让把念珠带进厕所的说法吗？是硬规则吗？啊、So this devotee said that isn't there a statement that we cannot bring japa beads into the toilet? Is this a fast rule?
Well, there's a difference. Somebody's going in to use the toilet, they're going in to take care of the body, natural needs of the body, and somebody else is on a job there. They're just simply the caretaker of the toilet. So it's different circumstance.
这个又是一个就是环境情况，这个情况不一样。一种情况呢是，就是去上厕所，去照顾他的身体的需要。在那种情况下是不带念珠进卫生间的。但是这种情况，另外一种情况呢，是讲到了他的工作本身就是看厕所的，这种情况是可以的。
And sometimes I'm cautious about leaving. If you don't take the beads into the toilet, then what do you do with the beads? Where do you put them? You're just going to leave them outside? You leave them outside, somebody may take them.
关键是如果你上厕所的时候你不带着念珠，然后呢，你把念珠放哪儿呢？如果你随便的放在，如果你放在厕所外面，那就会被人拿走了。
So I've lost beads like that sometimes. I had beads and I left them outside the toilet, went into the toilet, came back, the beads were gone. Somebody had stolen them.
Guru 说他自己曾经有一个体验，就是他上厕所的时候把念珠放在厕所外面，结果出来之后念珠被偷走了。
So you have to be careful.
所以要小心照顾好自己的念珠啊。
Yeah, we may not chant directly on the beads when we're going in to use the toilet, but sometimes we will take the beads into the toilet. Sometimes we have to.
我们可能不会在厕所里念诵，但是我们上厕所的时候，我们随身携带着念珠，好不让念珠丢了。
Okay, 下一个问题。
这个问题来自于刘传华，说我们因为嫉妒主才投生在物质世界，又说回归灵世界永恒和主在一起，这有点困惑，请Guru解惑。 So it is said that because of enviness we have taken birth in the material world, but yet it is that if weGo back to the spiritual world, we will stay with the Lord eternally. I felt puzzled. So please remove my bewilderment.
I don't get the bewilderment. What's the problem? If we've come into the material world because of envy, but if we go back, we will stay with the Lord eternally.
Right? 困惑在哪儿呢？就我们，
her question is, how did we come to fall into the material world?
Okay. 所以您的问题是，我们是如何，我们又是怎么堕落到物质世界的？问题是这个。
Yeah. So she's saying we came into the material world because we are envious of Krishna.But when we go back to Krishna, then we will stay there forever. We can, yes. So, You have to understand that living entity is a marginal potency. We have free will. Yeah, we can live either in the material world or in the spiritual world. Krishna gives us that free will. Where do we want to be? So when we go back to Godhead, if after some time we decide we want to come back to the material world, Krishna will allow us.
如果我们回到了灵性世界，倘若我们下决心，我们决定要去物质世界的话，主也会允许的，批准。
Of course, we have to be very stupid to do that.
如果是有这种决定的话，那是太愚蠢了。
Of course, we are. We are stupid.
而且我们确实愚蠢了。
We chose to come here. We left Krishna.
我们主动选择去物质世界，来到物质世界，决定离开灵性世界。So
we should be convinced. When we go back next time, we're going to stay forever.
所以我们就一定要下决心，下一次等我回到灵性世界，我再也不来到物质世界了。下一个问题。 有个Dharma，顶拜，顶拜Guru，念珠不能带厕所，出门旅行，如在火车上怎么做呢？ Since the Guru, the Dharma beast cannot, since the Dharma beast cannot be brought into the toilet, then if we go to travel on the train, what to do?
Yeah, so I said that sometimes you can't, yeah, sometimes you have to take the beads in with you. If you're traveling alone, and then you're on the train and you're alone and you have your beads with you, what can you do? You have to take the beads with you. Toilet.
你一个人出门在外坐火车旅行，那你不随身带念珠，那怎么办呢？
So that's why we have the beads in a bead bag to protect the beads.
正因为这个原因，我们的念珠通常是放在念珠袋里的，本身这个念珠袋就是为了保护念珠。
And if you like, you can put the bead bag in another bag to protect the bead bag.
如果你喜欢的话，你也可以把念珠袋放进另外一个袋子里头，来保护整个这个念珠和念珠袋。Okay,
下一个问题。下一个，什么可以抓的？听拜妈拉的奉献者，最近有圆顿法门的人进入
ISKCON， 他们进来的时候非常困惑，因为在那边学习梵歌瓦坛，但训示是不可以背离师门。 否则有严重恶报，他们被要求崇拜师父、师父、立女弟子为他的大房、二房、三房，佛母地位匪夷所思。他们被搞得晕头转向，十分害怕离开那个组织，但是心里明白这跟经典的教导背离很远。他们想知道这样被启迪或者赐予了灵性名字是否有效，可以离开他们进入 ISKCON 重新开始学习吗？感恩您。我们给大家的 questions that。 Based on the Guru Maharaj devotees, recently there are some devotees from Yuandun entered into the society of ISKCON. They felt very puzzled for their previous experience because in Yuandun they also learn Bhagavad Gita and Bhagavata, but the instructions that they can never deviate from their from their society, or else there will be severe karma reaction. They are requested to worship their teacher, and the teacher also put some female disciples as their wives, various wives, and put them into the position of the mother. So it's very, very precarious condition, and they themselves are also bewildered, and they in their heart they are afraid to leave that organization, although they know it is far from the scripture. They want to know, in that condition, if they are initiated or have got a spiritual name in that society, Yuandun, is it effective? And also, can they leave that Yuandun and enter into ISKCON to study again? Thank you.
Yes, you have to leave. You have to. That name you got in the Yuandun, that is not effective. That is not given through the parampara. He is not connected to the parampara. So that's not going to have any potency. So you have to come, you have to leave that society, and you have to come to the proper society.
因他们那种的启迪不是有效力的，他们没有跟使徒传习有连接，所以他们那种启迪没有力量，必须要离开，来到一个正确的协会。
You have to get reinitiation. You have to take proper initiation through the disciplic succession.
来到这边来得到正确的启迪，从而进入使徒传承。
So don't waste your time. Somebody's teaching you wrong, there's not going to be any effect. You're not going to get anywhere.
So 别浪费时间了。如果你得到的是一个错误的教导的话，你哪也去不了，你达不到任何的目标。
You're worried about leaving? If you don't leave, you're foolish.
现在呢？ 他们在担心如果自己离开会怎么办，如果是不离开才是愚蠢的事呢。
It's not going to help you, it's just going to make you more conditioned, you're just going to become more lost in your spiritual practice. You're wasting your time.
在那边呢，不会给你任何的帮助，只会使一个人越来越受到条件限制，更加迷失了自我。
So in the past we've had many people leave that group. They've came from Yuandun, they came to Krishna consciousness, and they've made good advancement.
在过去，我们有这些人，他们是从圆顿过来的，然后进入了 Krishna 之觉，取得了长足的进步。 下一个，刘传华，回归灵世界的老奉献者念珠怎么处理？ If one devotee have gone back to the spiritual world, how to deal with his or her japa beads?
Well, they can be used by. They can be put on his picture. If you have a picture of him, and you keep a picture of him in the home, then you can put the beads around his picture like a garland.
Whose home?
Well, the man who died, who went back to Godhead, he must have some family, probably. Oh. Has.
Okay, 他的家人，就是他的家，他原来住过的家就有他的照片，然后呢就把他的念珠呢就像花环一样就戴在他的那个照片上。
Usually we do like that.
一般我们是这么做的。
Just like as somebody is a sannyasi, then they put the beads at his samadhi, where the samadhi is.
一个 sannyasi, 就把他这位 sannyasi 的念珠就在他的 samadhi 的那个地方呢，就套在他的照片上。
Yeah. Okay, 下一个问题。
代表昌这位拉森尼，请教咕噜，在修习 Krishna 知觉过程中，当有恶业显现的时候，念诵圣名的品位是不会自动下降呢？So the guru, so during the course of practice Krishna consciousness, if there of a bad karma has appeared.Will our taste for chanting the holy name decreased because of that?
Well, if your bad karma appears, you should increase the chanting of the holy name.
如果恶业增显现的时候，你反而应该增加念诵圣名。
You should take shelter of the holy name. It will protect you from your bad karma.
应该托庇于圣名，这样才能保护一个人免受恶报的影响。
Your bad karma is appearing because you're not chanting good enough.
恶业之所以显现，是因为念诵质量不够好才显现的。
So you improve your practice of devotion and will protect you from all the bad karma.
增加奉爱的修行，这样就能保护我们免受恶报的袭击。
下一个问题。
没有恶报或者没有产生新的业报，行为念诵的质量和品位才会不间断吗？才是持续的。有品位有质量念诵的感恩故人子。If there is no bad karma or no new karma, our chanting, the quality and taste of the chanting. In that case, our chanting and the taste for the chanting will be consistent, no interruption.Is that a consistent? Is that a chanting with quality and with ruchi?
Well, you have to get through anartas before you come to ruchi. Ruchi is a very advanced level.
你必须得首先得去除你的那些 arnata, 就是多余的污染，才会达到有品位的念诵 ruchi。
But generally, you're a devotee doing devotional service. You're not going to get new karma and old karma. There's no, the karma's finished because you've surrendered to Krishna and you've taken up devotional service. So karma should not affect you.
因为你已经从事奉献服务了，所以就没有什么老旧的业报和新业报的问题。因为您臣服了 Krishna, 业报不应当影响到您。
So you just need to continue your practice. You have to do intense practice of sadhana, hearing and chanting, and then you don't have to worry about karma.
您只需要继续修行。而且是那种强烈的修行，特别的专注的修行，规范修行，聆听、唱诵，这样就能消除业报。
Okay.
Okay. Jumuki Radha said, thank you, Maharaj Guru Maharaj, for your mercy.
Uh-huh.
And next. 下一个 H, 顶拜孤乳和奉献者们。有人说奉献者离开躯体火化的时候，孤乳赐给这个奉献者的念珠要一起火化，是这样吗？ Obeisance to Guru and devotees, there is a statement from devotee that when somebody says that when devotee left their bodies, the japa beads that is given by the guru should also burn with the body. Is it true? Is it that true?
Not necessarily.
不是必须的，不一定。
下一个问题。
Finish, Mara, all the questions.
Oh, very good.
Today.
Okay, thank you very much. So, woman Ganshiya, Guru Mani, give woman funny, Ganshiya, soil the functions at Ling Ting, T1, Jufuni Man, Tang Song Kwaila, Srila Prabhupada, Ki.
Jai.圣巴迪维米纳什纳斯苏安玛拉给我们带来了精彩的早课和对所有问题的耐心解答，感谢主持 Krishna Kumar 的主持，感谢所有奉献者的聆听，祝大家在 Guru 的祝福当中过一个愉快的周二。 Hare Krishna。